I miss doing these interviews with you, mate. Right, Aki Kareem, BBTV. I am delighted to be joined by Macaulay McGowan, who has been looking for a fight for a while now, which we're going to talk about. But he finally got a date and a fight. Rohan Darte, or his name is his surname Date, or is it Darte?
I don't know. I've been calling him Rohan Date, so don't know. It might be Darte. I don't know. Might be.
Tell me about the show and, you know, all the details of it, mate.
To be honest, mate, I don't have a flipping clue. I'm going to tell you how this fight came about, right?
Well,
obviously, I've got myself in decent shape, and I just wanted to fight. So, a few fights fell through. Not fell through, but, like, we got a date for 14th of October, got given an opponent. We said, yeah, that fight didn't happen, whatever. So then, I was, like, just sat. I was on top of the scaffold, right? I was speaking to my mate. He was Britling. I was labouring for him there. I was on top of the scaffold. See that MGK had announced his show in Dubai. So I thought, old Maxi Hughes is on it. I'm playing Ireland, and they're from England. So they're obviously flying kids over from England. So I thought. So I just, like, Googled the names, you know, at the bottom. You know, like, you have, like, the main event, and then you have the lads at the names on the poster. So I Googled a few of them. Seeing one of them said he was a welterweight and he was he'd had 12 fights or 13 fights, drawn one. But he sort of thought, I'll chuck that one over to Kofi, who speaks to him a lot, you know, the boys in MTK and that. So I thought, what about that one? Anyway, I can ask. So I said, oh, I'll just try it anyway. So fucking, he threw it over, they accepted, and now I'm off to Dubai to fight. So yeah.
From Withenshaw to Dubai, that should be what the title of the video is called. But you know what? You know, I'm looking at this kid this morning, and you know he's 13-0, as you say, 9 KOs.
Yeah.
Looking at his, so you know he's got a very good record. Looking at his record, though, no disrespect to him, anyone on his record, I think you would have done the same too. You know, it's no disrespect to him.
Yeah, that's what I mean. There's no denying that. Like, obviously, he's knocking. What is it? 9 KOs. He's knocking 9 people over. So there's gonna be power there. But like, so what? Like, it's a fight. Like, people have power, that's so what? Like, fucking whatever, innit? Like, I'm gonna get hit at some point. Fucking, no point in me going over. He's got all his power, he's gonna hit me and he's gonna knock me out, so there's no point in me going over, is there? But fucking, that's not the case, is it? Like you say, obviously, people just stood there letting him smack him. I haven't really watched too much. I watch a bit, don't get me wrong, I'm not gonna sit here and say I don't. I have a quick scan through, but like, it's different when someone's in front of you who knows what they're doing, because the shots aren't there where you can just sling away. So it'd be different. Like you say, if I had boxed them kids and who had come over, I'd probably have a lot more knockouts on my record as well. But I don't look too much into it. I just gonna turn up and do what I do and fucking go to war, man.
You've been chomping at the bit, to be fair, to get out. I mean, for people who didn't know, you know, you was nearly a late replacement for Troy Williamson.
Yeah.
And I know you both, you know, you're both proper fighters. You're both like, yeah, I fight him, whatever.
Yeah,
let's do it. But it didn't happen. You know, why didn't that happen? Just clarify it if you don't mind.
Basically, I weren't really in a boxing gym. I've been fit, don't get me wrong, and I've been done bits here and there. And then I think I seen that Troy put that note, like, he's hard to get a fight. And you know when kids like that, they say, no one wants to fight him. I know what they're saying. Kids above him or kids about where with titles and stuff don't want to fight him. You don't mean like a randomer like me. He was just going to go, all right, well, I'll fucking fight you. So I get where I come from. I thought, I'm near that weight now. So I thought, like, I was just a bit over like the light middleweight limit. So I thought, yeah, why the fuck not? Like, I'm fit. Like, I'll just do a bit of sharpening up and I'll fucking, and I was confident of beating him. But, you know, it was all agreed. Money agreed, everything was banged on, ready to go. I was waiting all day for MTK to announce it on Twitter or whatever. IBF said, oh no, we're not going to sanction you because I've only done like 2-4 rounders in the last few years, and like, not against like the best opposition, no disrespect. But so then I just, my mind clicked then, right, I've got to get an 8-rounder against someone good, win, and then I'm ready to fight for the titles, then the international titles, or whatever, any other title that's available.
You mentioned Kofi there. Obviously, you've got a good connection with MTK. So, you know, you're signed with them. You're under the MTK banner now as well.
Yeah.
So that gives you a lot of scope, because they actually are able to put on the smaller shows as well as the bigger shows and feeding into the big promoters. So hopefully the start of a quite an active phase for you then, Macaulay.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, like I plan on beating Rohan and then look out to get out before Christmas again in another big fight. I just want to keep chucking it, getting stuck in, man. Like I'm confident of beating anyone in the country at welterweight. So I just want to fight. That's it. I don't care who you are. Like Kofi's like my manager's Johnny Roy. Don't get me wrong. Like and Johnny Roy and Kofi, nothing gets passed or happens without Johnny Roy going knowing or finger. It's just that. Like obviously, Johnny Roy's busy and he has his own fight. He's got Liam Conrad at the end of the month, so he don't need me going. Well, I'm in shape now. Get me a fight. It's like, well, where the fuck you been for how long? You know what I mean? So, yeah. Like nothing happens without Johnny Roy saying it, and Johnny Roy's like actually putting requests to the MTK main office himself about certain fights. It's just that Kofi's obviously like one of my best mates, so like he's like more personally invested, like. Get Mac of this, get Mac of that, and he has a personal relationship with, you know, guys in MTK and stuff. So we can just like he's like it probably annoys him, to be honest. There'd be some cunt in MTK, right, with a camera roll of me half naked of my transformation. Like, look at him, he's in shape, get him a fight. So
we've all been sent them pictures, mate. The half naked ones.
yeah, get him a fight. Look at him, he's like a Jack Russell. Like someone's like, oh, I finally let Mac off the leash. It's like I've let Kofi off the leash. You're like, get him a fight, anyone. So, but if I weren't so confident of that, I was willing to fight anyone, anytime, any place. I wouldn't let him be like that because I'd be like, oh, you know, rein it in a bit now, Kofi. You know what I mean? You know, like if it was a bit unsure, but I weren't because I'm literally not bothered. So. He's like pestered, and we finally got our opportunity. Now it's time to fucking deliver, I suppose.
You've got to deliver now, mate. All the way over there in Dubai, it's going to be streamed on IFL. You're going to have a lot of people watching. I've seen you training with Gary at the minute, Gary Booth. Are you training with Gary now full time?
Yeah, mate. Like, Gary's been like just the most committed guy I know. Like, he's unbelievable. Mate, I've been all over, like, throughout lockdown, I just got myself in shape and I've fucking been here, there and everywhere saying, I'm going to go back to this gym, I'm going to go back to that gym. And I fucking had it ended up anywhere. And eventually, the Troy Williamson fight didn't happen, so I thought, right, I just need to rein it in now. I have 2 weeks out, see what's ending up, because just had a lot of appointments on with my son and, you know, things here and there, like where I thought I can't really dedicate to being in the gym, but I can dedicate myself to being fit and like keeping myself in shape. So I just kind of like pulled myself away from being committing myself to a coach. And then my mate was going to Gary's, and I just like went along, and that was it. Gary said, I'll fucking train you before work and all that. He trained me after work if I wanted, train me in between work, train whenever I fuck I want. So I was like, and the training was bang on. He's got me boxing the way I want to box. He's got me training the way I want to train. And, you know, fucking out of nowhere, this has happened. So I'm really grateful for fucking Gary, man. He bang on. He's top.
He loves a holiday as well, Gary. you know, especially going to Dubai, top up his tan. He'll absolutely love that.
Yeah.
In fact, he went out there. I'm sure he went out to Dubai with Peter Fury and
Yuri. Saudi Arabia.
Saudi Arabia, that was it, yeah. Last time I spoke to you, you know, you said you was going to call yourself the Withenshaw Warrior. Yeah. Are you going to be officially the Withenshaw Warrior?
Fucking, I don't know. Shall I be? I mean, can you see me? Is the light still all right?
Yeah. Maybe, yeah, a bit. Like, you look darker than me, which is ironic.
Right. might be the Benchill Banger, though.
I like it. Benchill Banger.
What knows?
We put it to a vote because people will watch this video. Right, put it to a vote down below. Is it Withenshaw Warrior or Benchill Banger?
I don't know. I can't really say Benchill Banger. The record doesn't really back that one up, but fuck it. We'll throw it in the air anyway.
You said on your social media that you're really wanted to come and take over the division. I know it's a thing that fighters do say, but, you know, is that your mentality at the minute? I mean, you really want to just go in at all guns blazing and give it this proper go that we've been waiting for you to give it the proper go?
Yeah, like me. Fucking, what have I been a pro now? I've been a pro since. I went pretty much pro at 18, had my debut at 19, like through delays and that. I've been, most of my career, mate, I've been playing at it. In the gym, mate, I give it a go. But, like, my mentality is I'm not scared, so I'm just like, oh, it's just a fight, innit? So, like, if I'm dieting and I can't be arsed, I'll just eat a bit of shit. And then my last fight last year, when I knocked that kid out, mate, I did a run on the day because I wanted to eat the night before, like, loads of shit. It was on the day weighing, right? Fucking, I was about 12 stone. I had to weigh 11.8, which is heavy for me anyway. I'm not going to be in any good shape at that. I just thought, fuck it, I'll do a run. Sweat suited up, got the weight off, weighed in, and then fought a couple of hours later and ended up knocking the kid out. I've been messing a bit, but like, now, mate, I'm not far over welterweight limit now. Like, this fight's at 10.9. I'm just looking to, I just want to fight, and I believe that the fucking, in a few fights, I'm going to be up there, like, best in Britain. Like, I've put myself in with anyone. I've just got to have the rounds and prove it. Like, it's all right me sat here saying this, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. Oh, look at the transformation. Oh, he went from fat to skinny. It don't mean shit. None of it means anything. I've got to deliver on the 9th of October and then go on from there. Like, when I win on the 9th of October, I'll be straight back on it because I'm hungry for it, man. Like, honestly, I'm gonna any welterweight, mate, I'm gonna smash up serious. Like, it doesn't fucking matter.
Like, anyone can get it off McCauley.
Yeah, honestly, anywhere, anytime, any place, whatever the fuck you say. I think I've just said to anywhere, any place. I think that's the same thing. But whatever the saying is, it doesn't matter. Like, I've been waiting for this. I've just been waiting for a time where I just got my act together and, like, got the weight right where I was ready to go. Because people, like, you have mates who go, ah, don't you go, oh, why don't you call him out on Twitter or do whatever? Like, I can't do that because I'm about 13 stone. So if he says, well, there's a 5-6 week, I go, well, actually, fucking, I can't do it. So I've been waiting. So I've got myself in shape and I'm just ready to fight anyone now. So. It's a good fight against this Rohan. I'll beat him and then I'll move on.
It does look a good fight, actually, because his style, yeah, actually is come forward, pressure, throws big hooks. Yeah. So I think it's going to be an insane fight. I won't dwell on the weight situation, because I know in the past it's annoyed you. It's annoyed you with people asking you about it all the time. But yeah, you said you're going to... This fight's at 10.9, which obviously is only two pounds away from... Yeah, two pounds away from the welterweight limit. You know, what's been the difference to actually get you in that zone where you can make weight efficiently?
Yeah, well, I've just turned into a bit of a fucking savage, man. Nah, like, I did a bit of a thing for charity and stuff running over lockdown, and I think about May, I was still about 30.5 stone, 30 stone 10, something like that. I got in touch with my mate, he's a dietitian, he has qualified nutrition, Peter Bell, and honestly, if it weren't for him, I don't think I'd be in this position now, because he's been on me case, not on me case in like a dictator, like, yes, man, how are you? How's the weight? How are you feeling? How's the food? Literally every day. He's been like part of my bubble. He lives in Crewe, right? But every day my phone will message and he's on me. And like, if it weren't for him, just being on my case, being accountable to someone. Because it's all right saying, yeah, I'm gonna stay ready. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. But it's flipping hard, especially with no gym coming up at the time, there weren't no gym coming up or no training. So I just got in touch and said, look, mate, I want to do it this time. And he stuck by me. And like, we're just like, we've been hovering just over 11 now for a while. So we'll just bring it down a bit more. And then I'll be 10.9 pretty comfortable in 4 weeks' time.
Yeah, fair enough. Now, your opponent, were you about to talk? Sorry, go on.
No, didn't say that.
I was going to say, your opponent is actually, he was born in Manchester. His nationality is Irish. He lives in Dubai. So that's an interesting one. But you were about to talk about sort of the fight itself. You know, the fact that he likes his big hooks, he likes to put the pressure on. Yeah. And actually, that's kind of you as well, isn't it? But yeah, did you see this being a really entertaining fight?
Yeah, fucking, it's my time, isn't it? Like, entertainment, maybe. Like, woo, let's get it on, man. Fucking, listen, I love to fight. I probably love to fight more than I should, but I'm just going to go out there and see what happens. If I've got a fight, I'll let my heart rule my head and maybe I'll have to change that a bit. Like, if he fucking bangs on the chin a bit. But nah, fucking, listen, it's just a fight, innit? Like, it's all right. Like, people can overcomplicate it. Like, I know people say about Like, they talk about, like, all the facts I've gone through quite a lot this year and all, but it doesn't, it's irrelevant. Like, it's just a fight. Like, oh, it's in Dubai. It doesn't matter if it, I wanted to fight in Wakefield. Like, that thing, that's where ESPN are doing the shows, you know. Yeah. It didn't matter where I fight. I just want a fight. It's only because MTK have pretty much made fights borderless in the fact that they can get fighters wherever that this fight has come about. So, it's just, it's fucking, I'm just going to get in there, do the fucking biz and come home. Like, I'm not, it's one of them, innit?
You touched on, mate, having a tough year, and I hope you don't mind me asking, yeah. But, you know,
yeah.
people know, people in Manchester, yeah. Whatever, know.
Yeah.
You have had a tough, how is, you know, family situation at the minute, and, you know, and it's always tough when children are ill and things like that, really, I know the feeling, mate, and
yeah.
Just tell me how that's impacted you, and how do you think it will help you going forward, you know, with the boxing career?
Mate, it's made me a fucking savage. I'm a fucking savage now. Now, you know what? I don't know, like, it has been hard, like, to touch on it. He suffered a brain injury at birth. Like, he's good, though. Like, he's got high muscle tone, so that can be, like, that high muscle tone, like, he's a bit stiff, so it can be signs of, like, early signs of cerebral palsy and that, but he's bang on, you know what I mean? Like, he's sound, like, I couldn't give a fuck what's the matter with him, like, and the worst thing I want is, like, people to, like, be invested in me to, like, want a win because of that. Like, nah, I've been training me whole life to box. Like, don't get me wrong, he's given me a bit between my teeth. And, like any, having any children would. But, like, this one, don't know, quite, you learn to live with, like, the struggle a bit. But he's mint. And, like, he's just like any other kid. Like, he sits up, he's starting to go into the crawling stage and stuff. So maybe he might have a few problems with his milestones, but he's bang on, you know what I mean? Like, and I'll never know what, people will never know what's happened. Like, oh shit, are you still there?
I can still hear you. Yeah.
Yeah, just saying 20%. Yeah, I'll be all right though. And you just say, like, what was he up to?
You were saying people may not know really what's happened.
Yeah, what no, like, even medical professionals, because of his brain, like, it develops as he gets older. Like, we don't know, like, you might one day just start having fucking seizures or whatever. You don't know, but what can you do? Like, we all have this, like, perception of how our life should be, and like, life doesn't know what's good or what's bad. That's our own illusion of life. Like, we have a certain way of what we think about, and we divulge whether that's good or that's bad. Whereas life's just happening. So I don't think about it too much. I just crack on, and, you know, fucking, I'll say the word, like, it doesn't, what's happened doesn't discriminate. Sorry, it doesn't mean if you're rich, poor, black, white, Asian. It doesn't matter. Like, what's happened doesn't discriminate. So we're just all the same people, and, you know, what's happened's happened. You just got to learn to live with it. And, like, I think on my Twitter, the pictures, I put a quote, and it's just saying, like, you can't talk it away, you can't run it away, you can't punch it away. What's there is there, and what's happening is happening, and you've got to learn to love it and endure it and become a better person for it. So I'm just going with the flow, and fucking I couldn't be in a better position. Like, I couldn't be in a better place, really, to be honest with you. Like, no matter what, like, so.
Yeah, good. That's great to hear, mate. That's really great to hear. You know, this morning, me and Chris was showing, I said I was interviewing you, so we were sharing old video, old interviews that we've done with you over the past. They're absolutely bonkers interviews. They're hilarious interviews. People should go back and have a look. I mean, so entertaining. But, you know, that's just part of your character, isn't it? So,
yeah.
You know, I think the people in Dubai are not going to know what's hit them, really, when you arrive there for fight week.
Yeah, well, I was laughing to myself, thinking, what shall I, when you, this camera comes up, what shall I wear? What shall I have my girlfriend's bra on or something? But I thought, nah, I'll just act a bit more normal. When I'm talking, I think, fucking hell, I'm talking a bit too much now. Must think I'm on summit, but nah.
I feel just good. To clarify, he's not on summit. Yeah.
Yeah.
To clarify. Don't go putting that bit on Twitter saying.
Not today, anyway. No, I'm joking.
But you look in good shape already, to be fair. You know, the cheekbones are there, everything's good. It's good, and you definitely seem in a good place. And that's really, I know the boxing is the primary thing. Well, actually, no, that's not true. You know, but people's mental health and well-being is the primary thing. But the boxing follows on nicely from that.
Yeah, like, this is what I'm saying, like, fucking, like, I'm one of those people, when I'm in the gym, I'm a better person, I'm a better this, I'm a better father, I live my life better and stuff, you know, when I'm in the gym. And I thought, and that's wrong to be that way. Like, I always thought, like, a better athlete makes a better person, but you've got to be a better person to be a better athlete, I think. Like, in my view, I was reading a book about, like, the All Blacks and stuff, and they were saying, like, you got to be a good person before you're a good athlete. So I thought, so this lockdown, like, a new gym weren't coming, I thought, if I don't get my act together and find focus in something else or anything, then I'm just going to be wasting 4 months being an idiot. And God knows what's happening in 4 months. So I thought, I'm going to try and better myself. So I just thought, I'm just going to be a better person at home, a better dad, a better this. I'm a few principles with me running and dieting what I got to stick to, but not too strenuous. And I think when I went in the gym, I was better than ever. Like, I'm better than ever now, and I'm just going to keep winning. And I'm just gonna reach all the heights that I aim to reach for.
Mate, it sounds like
raw dog, baby.
There you go. There he is. I thought he was getting a bit too deep and philosophical for a second.
Nah, fuck getting deep, man. Fuck all this deep shit. I'm gonna smash every fucker clean up. We're coming, dude. Have you seen that video?
No, what is it?
Dad's real fantastic. And he goes, we're coming, dude. He says, I'm 21, you're 22. That's a fair match. But that kid here, he's 18. And he comes in, pretending to bite him.
I've not seen it, but yeah. Yeah, mate, what can I say? It's been great catching up with you as always, and we should definitely do this more often. We're just starting a new podcast, so you know, nearer the time. It's like a little radio show, so nearer the time, mate. It'd be great to get you on, you and Gary.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, get me and Gary. Fuck, imagine me and Gary on there. Fuck it.
It'll be class. It'll be absolutely class. Do you want to say any final shout outs to anyone?
Yeah. Big up all the man, them here. Cole Fett, big shout out to Cole Fett, Yellowstone, me boss Daniel Broadhead, Broadhead Developments, mate, been absolutely amazing. Peter Bell, you know, like I say, without him, like, doing my nutrition, I wouldn't be in this position. Fucking Gary, fucking Niall, Connor, fucking who else? Nah, like, I've won a world title, we've done a fucking interview. Just leave it at that, I think. Sorry if I've offended anyone by not giving you a shout-out.
Yeah, they'll get over it. All right, mate, it's been nice catching up with you, and I look forward to this. Seriously, I'm looking forward to this, and I hope you get a good active run now, mate, and all the best to you.
Active run? I'm going to punch his fucking head clean off. Wait, you're like, get this kid back on, and I'll punch someone else's head clean off. And then they get me back on again. I'll just keep punching heads clean off. You want some? I'll give it you.
See you later, mate.
All right, see you.